Thank you all for coming, particularly on pretty short notice. Today's press conference was not something that we wanted to hold or anticipated that we would need to. We've been brought together mostly through a self-inflicted problem. You know, close to half of our population has refused to get a vaccine that is safe. It is effective against severe illness, hospitalization, and death, and it's absolutely free for the asking. Those low vaccine rates have allowed the twice as contagious Delta variant of COVID-19 to spread like wildfire across the country and now our state. In response to the spike in hospitalizations and deaths, the CDC has updated its guidance to recommend making masking indoors in counties with high COVID-19 transmission rates. The CDC recommendations extends to all Kansans, vaccinated or not. This is happening because the Delta variant is significantly more contagious than previous variants. Just one person who is infected with COVID Delta can carry upwards of 1,000 times the viral load as a patient infected with a previous version of this disease. As I said yesterday, this administration has consistently followed the recommendations from the experts at the CDC. Per my authority under the state constitution, beginning next Monday, state employees, regardless of their vaccination status, will be required to wear masks indoors at work if they cannot socially distance. Additionally, anyone entering state buildings or facilities will also be required to mask up. As you can see on this map next to me, the new guidance was clear. If your county's COVID transmission rate falls into the red or orange zone, which means high or substantial risks of transmission, you should wear a mask. Just as my administration has worked over the last year to create solutions that empower local leaders, the CDC has recognized that the path forward in this fight has to start at the county level. In my role as governor, I have had to work to find consensus and compromise, especially in the heightened political environment in which we find ourselves. You know, last week, Alabama Governor Kay Ivey said that it's time to start blaming the unvaccinated for the situation we now find ourselves in. Those are pretty strong words. But I would add that this extends to any elected official that has put politics above public health over the last year, or stayed silent and allowed falsehoods and conspiracy theories to replace science and medicine. Playing politics with this disease has caused confusion and ultimately suffering and death. We know that almost every single Kansan who has COVID now and is in an intensive care unit bed is unvaccinated. By the time you reach the ICU, it is too late. The deaths from COVID Delta could have largely been avoided with a simple vaccine. Let me be clear, these vaccines are safe and they save lives, period. If you aren't vaccinated, I implore you to get yours today, tomorrow. I want those Kansans who wore masks and got their vaccine to know that I share your frustration. No one likes wearing a mask, myself included. I'm deeply appreciative of your willingness to protect your friends and neighbors through this pandemic, and I take no pleasure in asking you to put a mask on again. Over the next few weeks, we will continue our efforts to get Kansans vaccinated. My other immediate concern is for the well-being of our children going back to school in just a matter of weeks. Later this week, my administration will be releasing updated guidance for our school districts. As you know, school health decisions fall under the purview of the state and local boards of education. However, my administration will be standing by with guidance, support, and tools for any school district that needs our help to protect their kids. I know the last year has been extraordinarily challenging, but the circumstances have changed considerably. We have a vaccine, our economy is strong, and we are making great strides. But the Delta variant has put the people of Kansas at another crossroads. The bad news is that cases are rising in many parts of our state. The good news is that we have a vaccine to protect us from the virus that is safe, it's effective, and it's free. I strongly urge every Kansan who isn't vaccinated to get one right away. That's the best way, maybe the only way, to stop the spread of COVID in our state. For those vaccinated, I ask that you speak with your friends, your neighbors, your loved ones who are unvaccinated and encourage them to get vaccinated to protect themselves and our state. And with that, I'll take questions.
Governor, this applies indoors for state employees only if they can't socially distance or in?
This applies if they're not able to socially distance or in all public areas. So if you're walking in the hallways, you're on the elevator, you're in the bathrooms, those kinds of places, mask on. If you're in your own office and you're distanced from other people, you can take your mask off. It's pretty much the same we had when all of this began. We are really not focused on that at all. We are so focused on getting vaccines into the arms of people. We don't want to spend a lot of energy thinking about that or diluting our resources in ways that will distract from getting these shots in arms. Yeah, we are. You know, we've actually been looking at that for a while, but we're also evaluating what's been happening in other states. And we know that, you know, it's another tool, not necessarily the most effective tool, but we are going to try variations on that. We'll probably be making an announcement, you know, sometime next week that will give you an idea of what we've got in mind. It has to be something that's more immediate and that's more spontaneous. We know these planned out kinds of things really didn't have long-term positive impacts.
The Department of Veterans Affairs is requiring certain employees to be vaccinated. Is that something you're considering for certain state employees to have direct contact with people, or if you can start in vaccination?
You know, right now we're going step by step. You know, the CDC just came out with these guidelines yesterday. There was no vaccine mandate within that. Those guidelines. So right now we're going to implement the guidelines as the CDC put them forth yesterday.
There's all the things you can do with your, on your own authority.
Pardon me?
There's nothing here you said today that has to run through the LCC.
No, I have authority to you know, put in the mask requirements in our state buildings.
Governor, back to Katie's question on SB 40, there is still a larger question beyond COVID about, you could have another emergency that you would have to deal with. At this point, do you guys, or does the administration know what emergency management law you're working under, whether it's COVID, a tornado, fire, what have you?
Well, I think, Brad, as you know, the judge has made it very clear that there is no stay on this, this particular point. So from our perspective, we've reverted back to pre-SB 40 and the original KEMA Act. And so if we happen to have a flood soon, you know, we would be able to implement the emergency declaration. You know, the difference with those, and, you know, we're not thinking about one for anything COVID related, but we have to leave the options open for things like floods, wildfires, tornadoes. Well, you know, as I said in my remarks, I'm as frustrated as any other vaccinated Kansan. I feel like I did my part, and one of the rewards of that was not having to wear a mask. But, you know, that option has now been taken away because of the Delta variant and how much more contagious it is, and how few Kansans, unfortunately, have gotten vaccinated. So we just really don't have an option but to do that, because we need to protect. Even those who are vaccinated can still get the Delta variant and can be contagious, and we just can't have that, particularly in our schools, where we will have kids who are not eligible for, there is no vaccine for them. So this is a measure we just absolutely have to take to protect the health and safety of all Kansans, including our kids.